In this video, I talk about Marvel's latest installment of the Guardians of the Galaxy movie, Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2. Okay, so I'm not a Marvel comic book guy or a DC I'm not a comic book guy, period. Occasionally I'll read some graphic novels and stuff, but really I just don't get into comics, but I do get into the Marvel universe when it comes to movies. And I really, really thought Guardians of the Galaxy was fantastic, the original one, and this one is no different. Look, they've got a formula that really, really works, and I think that Ridley Scott, you know, with his Prometheus and Alien Covenant debacles, should go ahead and take a look at the formula that Marvel is using, because they've got it down. They've got it perfected. Now, they're not trying to do creepy horror, right? But I could easily see you taking the Marvel formula and applying it to Ridley Scott's films and improving the scripts tremendously, okay? You don't have to make the settings like the Marvel settings or whatever, but you definitely need to come up with a better way to do scripts, Ridley, and these guys got it going on. Now, the Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2, one of the things they do perfectly is they keep the cast small. The main character cast is small, 6 or 7 people, and you really learn their foibles, you really learn what gets them going, what makes them angry, etc., and it's just done perfectly. Now, I've seen previous reviews of people who got to see the movie early saying that they didn't like the way Rocket was portrayed in this movie. I thought it was great. Yes, he's negative. He's very negative throughout the movie, but there's an explanation why. There's a resolution to his anger and what's really troubling to him. And at the end, you come to have a greater appreciation of this raccoon hybrid, right? Genetically engineered. And I really liked the character 10 times more at the end of this movie than I did at the end of the Guardians of the Galaxy 1. And I liked him pretty well back then. So for me, that particular plot element worked really, really well. Drax was brilliant in this movie, had some great lines. There's some people complaining about, I think it was Red Letter Media again, and I sometimes I don't understand what those guys are talking about. I mentioned them in my earlier review here. But there's this complaint from those guys that there's a joke that keeps getting replayed throughout the movie and it gets old. I don't think that's the case. It gets revisited like 3 or 4 times, right? And it worked. I didn't find myself going, you know, when I realized what they were talking about. Yeah, the joke gets redone. It works. A lot of the jokes in this movie work really well. The audience was just cracking up, right? This is a movie that will not disappoint you, okay? The main character, oh my God, I can't believe I'm drawing a blank on the main character of Guardians of the Galaxy. Chris Pratt, whoever that character is, it's Star-Lord, but I can't remember his real name. But anyway, he finds his father. He goes back to his father's home planet with Drax and with Gamora. Zoe Saldana, I think is the name of the actress who plays Gamora. There's a new character, Mantis, who's played really well. And Drax and Mantis have some amazing interactions. Drax is awesome. There are some scenes where, I'm not going to bother trying to reenact them, but there are some scenes with Mantis where he basically looks her in the face. And, you know, Drax basically tells the truth no matter what. And he tells her she's really, really ugly, which is not the case. She's totally beautiful. But Drax has his, you know, he's from a different planet and has his own tastes, and he likes women with meat on the bone, you know, and it's just really funny. So at the end, you know, what it turns out happening is that Star-Lord, you know, Chris Pratt's character's dad, turns out to be a really evil dude and a godlike figure. And so these guys have to all join together with Michael Rooker's character, Yondu, who makes a reappearance here. And you really get to see, kind of the closing of the relationship between Yondu and Star-Lord, you know, and it's really, really well done. And toward the end of the movie, I got to be honest, I felt a little bit choked up, right? I didn't cry or anything like that, but I definitely, as a dad, I totally related to what was going on here. And so there's something for everybody. I took my kids to this. They loved it. I loved it. Everybody loves this movie, and for a good reason. It's just really well done. So I'm not going to really go into many of the spoilers, although I already did. I'm going to wrap it up here because this is a movie where it's still in the theaters. If you haven't seen it yet, go and see it now. It's worth your time. This is a movie that really makes Alien Covenant look like a piece of crap, okay? This is the difference between a movie that, you know, makes tons of dough at the box office but might not make any win any awards.
Just who in the hell do you think you are?
Well,
that was awesome.
He's so cute.
What's that?
He says, welcome to the frickin' Guardians of the Galaxy. Only he didn't use frickin'.
Look out!
Oh, wow. I tried, guys.
And a movie that was maybe going for awards or art or something and sacrificed plot for that, you know, Alien Covenant was just, it didn't work. It was majorly disappointing. You know, this is a movie that won't disappoint you at all unless you're somebody who doesn't like comic book based movies, in which case, you know, you won't like any of this. But I loved it. So definitely go see it. End transmission. Hey y'all, thanks for watching. Look, now that YouTube is censoring everybody, we all need to work together. So please, click the thumbs up on this video, subscribe to my channel, and do one small thing for me. Share this on social media. Share it on Twitter, Facebook, I don't care which. Everything, every social media thing you're subscribed to, however little you're willing to do, however much. Also consider buying my books. I'm an award-winning author, and you get what you pay for. You'll at least have some enjoyment out of them. I'm not asking for charity. Take a look at my books. All the links are below. Thanks for watching.
Where's a braided chain? Made of finest silver from the north of Spain. A lock.